Yes, it's finally here, inline editing for Beaver Builder, and I'm going to show you it in this video. Hi, my name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make WordPress tutorial videos for non-techies. If you're new here, consider clicking on the subscribe button. If you don't want to miss a thing, click on the bell off to the right. YouTube will let you know when I have a new video. Anything I talk about will be linked in the video description box down below. Now, I am going to show you something new that just came to Beaver Builder, which is the page builder for WordPress. And I have a little experience with this. So if you go to, if you already have Beaver Builder, it's already in your members area. And it's the alpha version of 2.1 of Beaver Builder that isn't fully vetted and out yet. But the Beaver Builder developers are super reliable in what they push out. Even their alpha version of any kind of update is usually pretty stable. That being said, I'm not putting it on my live site. But it's definitely something to check out. And if you look at the changelog, the big feature that has come, well, there's two big features, but the main one for this video is inline editing. And it's something that I'm so glad that they brought. And I think it's one of those things I'm going to show you in a moment that people over time are going to learn to love. There's also a couple other little goodies that we might bump into in this video. We won't be bumping into this, but it now, Beaver Builder now has some Gutenberg support. So they're getting all their ducks in a row ready for Gutenberg to come out. And there's this really neat notification center that they just added. I think that's really cool for staying in touch with their customers. All right, let's jump in. So I already have it open right here. It's a page that I created, named it Inline Editing. Now, not every module in Beaver Builder or the add-on packages are going to be compatible with this inline editor. So I'm going to show you the difference in this video. But one of the things I've always appreciated about any update or feature that comes to Beaver Builder is that it always looks very well thought out. Like they considered all of the angles with it to make sure when they implement it, they do it the right way. And this inline editing feature is exactly that. So I'm using the Chrome web browser, and also it's worth noting that I have the Grammerly Chrome extension. That's an extension that's generating this G right here. And what that does is it spots spelling errors. So if I spell anything wrong or maybe make a grammatical mistake, it's going to let me know. So you can see that's also working in the inline editing. So you can see when I hover over this is the title, you have those normal module controls in the left area of the module. But when you click, you see those disappear and then it pops up into the editing. That might have happened a little bit too fast. Let's do it over again. I'm going to click out. I'm hovering. I've got the normal module controls. Keep your eye on it. They're blue. Now watch what happens. I click and now you see some inline editing controls. Now because I'm editing a heading, it's only giving me bold, italics, and strike through. However, I do think that they should consider adding additional controls for headings. Now these additional controls, you're going to see them in the normal text boxes. So if I scroll down right here, let's see if this is a normal text box. When I click on it, nope, this is actually using a heading. This right here is a normal text box. I know that for sure. Watch when I click now. Bam. Now I get additional text formatting controls. So in the normal text box, I'm getting the ability to create a hyperlink and also getting alignment options. Now, I do think that for headings, they should add this as well, because I find myself when I'm editing a heading in Beaver Builder, you normally would put it here, I'm manually entering strong or something like that, just those little bits of HTML to make my headline look better. And I think that they should add that to the heading as well. Actually, take this as a suggestion. This is very early. I'm sure that will actually come. I like when I have my heading. Let's see, click here. Another thing that I'm realizing is missing is underline. I would like to highlight it and then underline it. It gives me the cross out so I can do the cross out like that, but it's not giving me the underline. So I think they need to add bold and underlining for headings, and I'll make sure they get that message. I'm sure they will. This is very early, but it's very powerful and I really like what happens. So watch, I'm on the text box. When I click, if you noticed, the controls go up. And that's because if it didn't go up, the controls would actually get in the way of what you're entering in. And as you can see, Grammarly is working perfectly with this little box of text. And you know, it's just like inline editing, you can type it in or whatever. And you can see it's also carrying over into the text box there on the right. Now that's Grammarly generating this red underline, and it's a great free service. I definitely recommend it. It saves me a lot of mistakes that I make. I'm a notorious bad speller because I type too fast. So now let me show you an example where this is not going to work. So when we look at the change logs, they make a distinction right here. It says they added inline editing for all modules, including third parties that support live text preview. Now, not all modules support live text preview. Let me show you that right now. So I know specifically with Beaver Builder, a perfect example is going to be the pricing table. So I'm going to so it's going to be pretty much pricing tables, accordions, tabs, things of that nature. And I think they might have just had them all grouped perfectly right here. Tabs, accordions, sidebar, pricing table. Yep, that's probably it. Okay, so I got my pricing table here. It doesn't have any information in it yet. So when I click on it, this is a example right here of there being no live text preview. So this is because I can duplicate this to create multiple price boxes. And to actually get the info into the price box, I have to click here. And now I can start entering information. So I could put title like that. And you notice as I entered title, it didn't appear here. I would have to click on save, and then it's going to say title here in a moment. There it is. And this is what will not have that inline editing. So I can click on it and you see nothing happening. And that's actually very reasonable. So what you need to do is just be aware of that, that I'm sure maybe they'll come up with a way to support live text preview in those other modules. I really think it would be nice if they would have it everywhere that there's text. Now, I want to address something with regards to live editing like this. Now, some people think that it's not needed, and the Beaver Builder developers tend to have a lot of discipline of what they add because they're really caring for their entire user base. I think that the people that are saying inline editing is not useful just have not used inline editing. And I will tell you, because I have been using inline editing in a different page builder extensively, it is very, very useful to be able to type your text and format it all, seeing how it's actually going to look on the front end. So right here, when I'm entering anything in this text box, I will be able to see exactly how it's going to look on the front end. But if you're typing here, it's just not the same thing. I think what I noticed with me is when I started using inline editing, I realized I love inline editing. It is super convenient to decide how you want your text to look, to format your text, to make quick edits. It is very, very helpful, useful, and it will speed things up, especially if you have clients that you give access to the sites that you make for them. It's going to be make it very easy for them to edit a little word or misspelling or underline something. It's going to make it very easy for them to do that. So I just want to hand it to Beaver Builder for listening to the community. I know I was one of the people out there saying this is something that you have to add to Beaver Builder. It has to be them that do it, not a third-party developer, but Beaver Builder themselves needs to implement inline editing. I love how they did it. I love how they have already, even though this is an alpha, have thought through most of it. Now, I would like them to add more options to headlines, like I was talking about, so I can underline headlines. There could be a word in a headline that I make strong, which is essentially making it bold. I would like to see that as well. And before I end this video, I want to show you that little notification center. So this is new right here. There's this little bell. And when you click on it, there's a little notification center. So I'm assuming they can push notifications to people using the builder and when they're in the builder. And I think that's actually very helpful because I want them to have a direct line of communicating important things to me. And knowing them, they'll use this very sparingly and responsibly. So that is it. Beaver Builder 2.1. I'm sure it's going to go through the beta testing and all of that, and it's available right now. I might actually try it. I like to live on the wild side. I might actually try it in my websites that I have Beaver Builder on just to see how stable it is, but I'm pretty sure it's rock solid. If you don't have Beaver Builder, I have a link in the video description box for it down below, or you can visit WPCrafter.com/Beaver Builder. That will actually take you over to my website where I'll give you some information about a training course that I've put together for Beaver Builder. It's normally $199. However, if you purchased Beaver Builder, didn't have it, and you wanted to purchase it, and you did it through that link that's on that page, there'll be information there about how I can get you that course for free. So that's it for this video. I guess if I wanted to end it with a question of the day, what do you think about inline editing and its usefulness? Or do you think it's just a gimmick? Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video.